Good evening, everybody. A hearty welcome to the Vicennial celebrations. And with the beginning, I would like to announce the generous hearts who had contributed for the printing and publishing of our Vicennial memoir. With the notion of recording and documenting all the happenings in our school, all these 20 years since its inception, the Vicennial memoir was planned. As soon as the cover page was unveiled, an open call was given for all those who were interested to contribute for the printing. And here came the answer from many of the liberal souls who came forward to contribute generously. It's a pleasure to announce the names of those generous hearts. To begin with, the IIT Foundation from ROA Publishers. Nextly, the EDAC Publishers, the KIPS Publishers, not only the publishers, we had even parents contributing towards the successful publishing of the magazine. We would like to announce the names of the parents. Mr. K. Prasad, father of Cherub of 5th A. Mr. D. Naveen Kumar, parent of D. Darshini of 4th A and Abhinav Vardhan of 6th B. Mr. Abbas Reza, father of Sakina Fatima of 1st A. Mr. Leo Rego and Mrs. Pramila Pinto, the parents of Ashmita Maria Rego of 9th A and Nishita Leona Rego of 5th C. Mr. K. Suresh, father of Bharadwaj of 10th A. Mr. K. Prasad Babu, father of Sadhvi Roslin of LKG A. Mr. C.H. Venkata Ramesh Kumar, father of C.H. Srivani of 9th A. Mr. Venkat Rami Reddy, father of M. Bhavyesh Balaji Reddy of Nursery and Akansha Sri Reddy of UKGC. Not to forget the contribution of the students of 10th standard, 10th A, B and C, and also the students of 8th standard. And one more parent added to the list, Mr. Suhaib Ulf Faizan, father of LKG student. Nextly, the donations even came from the robotics department, the Never Skip Publishers, and also the transport department. We would ever remain thankful for all these generous souls. Moreover, even our teachers had contributed for the successful printing of the Vicennial memoir. A heartfelt thanks to all the kind-hearted people. Thank you.
परिशुद्धात्मनः स्तोत्रं क्रीस्तु प्रभात्मकम् परिशुद्धात्मनः नित्यं स्तोत्रं శతసహస్రకం స్తోత్రం శతసహస్రకం అఖిలాకాశ పాసకం హల్లెలూయేతి నిత్యాహి కరాభ్యాచన మామ్యహం కరాభ్యాచన మామ్యహం. ఆదియు అంతము సమస్తము అయిన వారిని ఆకాశమంతటిని ప్రకాశింపజేయు వానిని హల్లెలూయా అని చేతులతో నమస్కరింతు. పాతుర్వహ పరిశుద్ధాత్మా సర్వకార్యేషు సర్వదా క్రీస్తు రాజ్యం సదా పూజ్యం సానందవర్ధకం భవే.
Thank you. Good evening to one and all. It's truly a delightful evening to welcome you all with a diligent red carpet, for it's a perfect ambience set for the Vicennial celebrations marking 20 years of successful schooling. A cordial welcome to all the dignitaries, guests and parents. I request the reception committee to pin the badges to our president, Mother Antonamma, the Superior General, Chief Guest, Miss Leka Sister, Global Talent Strategist, Guests of Honor, Sister Ignatius Suman, the Provincial Superior, Father Allam Arogya Reddy, Secretary to Hyderabad Archdiocese Educational Society, Mr. Boyapati Arogya Reddy, President and Chairman of St. Mary's Educational Society, Hyderabad. Guests of Honor, Sister Rose Pushpa, General Education Consultant, Father George Reddy, Parish Priest, Madinaguda, and Sister Anne Margaret, Superior of St. Anne's Convent, and all the fathers and sisters gracing the occasion. The Indian culture, with all its grandeur, welcomes the guests with all its solemnity. Let's all
stand and welcome the dignitaries. All the dear parents, students,
Thank you.
Now, I request the President, Reverend Mother Antonamma, the Manager of Schools and Colleges, Society of St. Anne, Firangipuram, to kindly declare the Vicennial celebrations open.
I, Sister Antonamma, Manager of Schools and Colleges, declare that St. Anne's High School Madinaguda Vicennial celebrations open.
Thank you, Mother. I request all our dignitaries, the President, the Chief Guest, and the Guests of Honor to release the balloons and mark the commencing of the event.
లైవ్ ఇవా సార్ లైవ్ ఇవా మీరు అడిగిన తర్వాత చెప్తాను.
థ్యాంక్ యూ ఆల్ ద డిగ్నిటరీస్.
Lighting the lamp. St. John chapter 12 verse 36 says, believe in the light while you have the light, so that you may become children of light.
It is good to light the lamp of love in our hearts, the lamp of abundance in our home, the lamp of compassion to serve others, the lamp of knowledge and wisdom to dispel the darkness of ignorance, and the lamp of gratitude for the abundance that the Divine has bestowed on our St. Anne's family throughout these 20 years.
The lamp leads us from darkness towards light. It burns only to give message of peace and light to the people around us.
As the presence of fire ensures success, it is symbolically proved that we have completed the journey of 20 years in building up St. Anne's Institution.
We are extremely thrilled to have with us the extraordinary personalities with a character of great heights, a prophecy of distinctness, and an originator of multifarious notions who have made our congregation proud.
As Jesus is the light of the world, we consider them as the light for our congregation. And these special personalities are in our midst today to double our joy. Now, we invite Reverend Mother Antonamma, the President of the program, with a white balloon to come and lead the lamp of Jesus.
Grace means undeserved kindness. It is the gift of God to us in the form of Saint Anne, who is our patroness, showering abundant blessings upon our institution throughout these 20 years. Blue color represents grace, and we wish to show our gratitude to her by lighting the lamp of Saint Anne. It's a great honor to call up our chief guest, Lake Sister, to come with a blue balloon and kindle the lamp of our patroness Saint Anne.
As the color red stands for love, joy and courage, which are imbibed in our foundress mother Tadipathri Gnanamma, it's our privilege to honor her who carries on the legacy of our congregation by spreading love, peace and joy. Now, we invite our provincial superior, Sister Ignatius Suman, with a red balloon to light the lamp of Mother Tadipathri Gnanamma.
The color yellow symbolizes happiness, positivity and energy. This color can be associated with the life of Saint Francis of Assisi, who gave up his life of wealth to live a life of poverty. So, we invite Reverend Father Allam Arugyareddy, the representative of Archdiocese of Hyderabad, with a yellow balloon to lit the lamp of Saint Francis of Assisi.
Growth, harmony and freshness represent the color green, which can be compared with the qualities of our co-founder Father Theodore Digman. We invite Sri B. Arugyareddy, the chairman of St. Mary's Educational Society, with a green balloon to come and kindle the lamp of Father Theodore Digman.
We request you all to stretch out your hands towards the lighted lamps to receive the light of life.
Thank you, one and all.
Kindly be seated.
Thank you, sisters, father, madam, and sir. 21st being the memorial day of Mother Gnanamma, we go to our reminiscences to commemorate the deeds of the great soul, Mother Gnanamma, our foundress. Mother Gnanamma's courage and willpower is beyond description. Her aspiration to bring education to the deprived girls is something worth admiring. It's time to pay tribute to the great soul, Mother Gnanamma, the servant of God. Our foundress, Mother Nyanamma, was a woman of grit and courage. Her selfless service to the society will ever be remembered in now and forever too. Mother Nyanamma, with a vision to impart quality education to everyone alike in this universe, is a marvel on the earth. With the thought of preparing the future generation with the strong weapon of education, which would empower each and every one of us, is worth commemorating and being honored. This day, as we celebrate our 20 years of schooling, the Vicennial celebration, we remain indebted to the great accomplishments that have taken place just because of the efforts taken by Tatipatri Mother Nyanamma. Though she was born and brought up in an ordinary family, her visions were far and far. Father was her deeds, such that she remains an example for us even now.
Good evening, everyone. It's my pleasure to introduce ourselves to you. He's Ashwin, and I'm Nishita. Give praise to the Lord, proclaim His name. Make known among the nations what He has done. Sing to Him, sing praise to Him. Tell of all His wonderful acts. Glory in His holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
The 20 years of our journey, right from the foundation till date, has been a cherishable period of time with all the moments of accolades, victories, merriments, establishments, new venture, pioneer introduction, collection of success stories of students, flourishing, inauguration, renovating infrastructures, that despite all trials and tribulation hovering. This could be all possible just and just because of the mighty hand of the God on the ascendant from the Most High.
Giving thanks is all that we can do to show our gratitude for all the blessings bestowed on us one after the other incessantly. Now the fifth students are here with a thanksgiving hymn. Standing.
We will not get tricked.
Thank you.
May this offering find grace in his eyes, and may his blessing continue to pour upon us now and forevermore.
Thank you and enjoy this evening.
Sparkle defines the diamond. Aroma defines the spice. Warmth defines the friendship, and humanity defines our principle. Just like a honeybee gathering nectar to make a full-fledged honeycomb, our sister is ever curious to gather knowledge and update our school to the more self-sufficient institution. It's indeed a privilege to have such an eminent person as our principal. I request our principal to address the gathering.
Good evening, everyone. A delightful welcome to the dignified guests here, diligent parents, disciplined students, and determined staff, and the dazzling crowd here. I heartily welcome you all to this prestigious occasion of our St. Anne's High School Vicennial celebrations. It gives me immense joy as I reminisce over the 20 glorious years of St. Anne's existence and growth. My heart fills with love, admiration, and gratitude for the fertile soil which the school provides to the Anneites who enter its portals to live as responsible human beings in the field of education in the city of Hyderabad. Today is a special and memorable occasion, one that we will remember in the year ahead. This moment is made more special with the arrival of our President, Mother Anthonamma, Superior General, Manager of Schools and Colleges, our chief guest, Lekha Sister, Global Talent Strategist, who loves to sacrifice for the sake of St. Anne's, her precious agenda, our very special guest, Reverend Sister Ignatius Suman, Provincial Superior of Hyderabad Province, who is never tired of doing something good and different, the noble personality of Reverend Father Allam Arogya Reddy, Secretary to Hyderabad Archdiocese Educational Society, who accepted to be here in spite of his busy schedule. My heart beats with joy in celebrating Vicennial of our school along with our guest of honor, Reverend Sister Rose Pushpa, General Consultant for Education, Reverend Father George Reddy, Parish Priest of Madinaguda, and our dear sister Anne Margaret, our superior, who have a sense of commitment which creates an apt platform for us to grow. I feel proud and privileged to be the part of this magnificent institution. At this juncture, I gratefully acknowledge the human service rendered by the visionary predecessors, dedicated teachers, and ever-supporting parents who have worked selflessly and tirelessly to bring glory to God and honor to our school. May God bless them with many full blessings. I am pleased to acknowledge that St. Anne's School lays its stress not just on academic excellence, but on character formation. It motivates students to always aim high and cultivate moral values as a first place for the divine, integrity of character and maturity in behavior, pursuit of excellence and creative genius, respect of the human person with an emphasis for elders and teachers, loyalty to the nation and a balanced understanding of the prevailing global situation. At St. Anne's, our approaches to learning is child-centric, encouraging activity based on learning and inculcating a scientific temper and a spirit of free inquiry. In our curriculum, the student is the primary focus and each child is involved in the learning process. We are constantly improving our teaching methodology so that it turns learning into a combination of classroom study, research and scientific discovery. The parents are the most strengthening power in molding the future of children. Their consistent support empowers us to do more and more. I pay my gratitude to them for their faith in us. I am confident enough that the Anites will make themselves stronger day by day, adding a new leaf to the grandeur of the school. I can foresee that every child who has entered the temple of St. Anne's School with its motto, Light of Life, will certainly reach the heights of glory. On behalf of the management, staff and students, full of engaging elation and soulful musical execution, welcome you all to this celebration of floral flow of musical feelings and glow of stunning dealings with ardent pleasure. And thank you for your generosity and fountain of the spiritual support, your concern and your accompaniment in our growth. My love and admiration for the administrative staff, along with our sisters, Sister Sunita and Sravani, for their cooperation. My special thanks to our community sisters for their prayerful support. To mark the Vicennial celebrations today, our teachers, along with the dance choreographer, became choreographers of their students, are rocking to stage, and we welcome you and wish you all a splendid time with all our kids today. Wishing you all God's blessings. Thank you.
Thank you, sister, for the inaugural address.
The exquisite artwork painted in the air by light and water touching the earth and the sky is a marvel of nature beyond description. Its colorful hues not only remind us of the covenant between God and man, but also gives us an assurance that how much ever bitter our days are, there are certainly going to be colorful days in the near future. Each hue of color has a story to tell.
Violet. Violet stands for spirituality, purification, gentleness, creativity, and royalty. St. Anne's High School invites God's fear and holiness among the students through novena, prayers, and meditation. Indigo. Indigo stands for sincerity and devotion. Our institution induces these traits of honesty and dedication through the values of the month. Blue. Blue stands for trust, stability, and confidence. We, the Anites, are tended and mended to bloom into trustworthy people by keeping our promises. Green. Green stands for renewal, harmony, safety, and energy. We, the future citizens, are taught to renovate our spirits to bring peace and extend protection to the girl child. Yellow. Yellow stands for hope, happiness, and optimism. We, the rising stars, are guided to aim high and overcome every obstacle with tremendous positive energy and experience the happiness of victory. Orange. Orange stands for determination and encouragement. We, the blooming buds, are brought up such that we remain consistent in our ideologies and practice perseverance in whichever aspect we are into. Red. Red stands for strength, passion, and love. Love reaches beyond all horizons. Hence, our mentors inculcate the habit of sharing, caring, consoling, and supporting each of our fellow beings. As all these colors blend together to make the magnificent rainbow, and then the spectrum converges to the white light, so do the anites flourish in leaps and bounds, yet sticking to the roots with all the ethics and morals intact in them.
A hearty welcome to all the well-wishers gathered here.
మంది ఇటు కొంతమంది అట్టేమో
బాగా చెప్తున్నానా
రానమ్మ ఇప్పుడు పోదు 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 టైం